Greetings. The Bible foretells many interesting signs for the end times, the last days. Matthew 24:7, there will be famines in various places. And I suppose a skeptic would quickly claim there have always been famines. I cannot blame them for trying to take that approach to dismiss signs they don't want to see. Matthew 24:7, there will be earthquakes in diverse places. And again, I think a skeptic would quickly claim there have always been earthquakes, probably as long as there has been an earth with plate tectonics. Homosexuality would increase at the end of the age, 2 Timothy 3:3. And you know those skeptics. They think one counterexample disproves a theory they wish to ignore. They'll point to the rampant pedophilic homosexuality in ancient Greece and claim it was a good thing. Many wars would erupt, Matthew 24:6. Oh, those skeptics. They would claim as long as there have been two tribes and one hunting ground, there have been wars. And it's our newfound ability to embed journalists with troops that just make us aware of more wars. The institution of marriage would be forsaken by many, 1 Timothy 4:3. Well, you know how modern women have been liberated from the need for a man. I mean, they can go to space now. In rockets conceived, designed, assembled, tested, operated, and piloted by men. But women don't need men, so it makes sense to throw off the bondage of marriage and become a lesbian. At least that is what a skeptic would say. And there are many other signs that skeptics would just as quickly and flippantly dismiss and ignore. And the Bible also says men will not see and recognize and be convinced to repent by the signs. Which kind of makes the skepticism and scoffing another sign. 2 Peter 3:3. First of all, you must understand that in the last days scoffers will come, scoffing and following their own evil desires. Jude 1:18. They said to you, in the last times there will be scoffers who will follow their own ungodly desires. But I think there is one sign that is often overlooked. It is simply too fantastic. Until now. Revelation 16:21. And there fell upon men a great hail out of heaven, every stone about the weight of a talent, and men blasphemed God because of the plague of the hail, for the plague thereof was exceeding great. In another translation, huge hailstones, each weighing about 100 pounds, fell from the sky on people, who cursed God because the plague of hail was so terrible. Now there are a couple of interesting observations I want you to make with me. First, depending on where you look, a talent is roughly 75 pounds, although some translate it as 100 pounds. That's pretty big, given the record American hailstone is 2 pounds. July 27, 2010. World record hailstone weighed in Vivian, South Dakota. A small South Dakota town is being recognized for a big find in last Friday's storms. It was Friday afternoon when a line of thunderstorms fired up in central South Dakota. High winds, heavy rains, and even a possible tornado rolled through the town of Vivian. But now, days later, a hailstone picked up just moments after the storm is getting worldwide attention. The damage is proof that it wasn't a typical South Dakota thunderstorm. Holes were punched through the tops of buildings, and Les Scott will never forget what it sounded like.
Guy throwing bricks at the house and many of them. It was scary, Scott said.
Scott watched as massive hailstones pummeled the ground. Tuesday, the dents in the ground were still visible, some as large and deep as coffee cans. But when the hail stopped, a certain stone grabbed his attention. Notice, holes were punched through the top of buildings. Scott originally wanted to make a daiquiri out of the hail, but decided to contact the National Weather Service instead Tuesday, they were in Vivian. They carefully took the stone from the freezer and placed it in a cooler of dry ice. The next stop was at the post office, where the Hale had a date with the federally certified scale. Moments later, the hailstone weighed in at 1.9375 pounds. Officially, where records have been kept, this will be the U.S. record and world record for weight. So very impressive, Mike Fowle of the National Weather Service said. So the record is a 2-pound hailstone. And coming down, they sounded like bricks being thrown at a house, and lots of them. And holes were punched in the tops of buildings. Allow that to sink in. Pardon the pun. And second, notice from the verse that men will curse God. They will not recognize the sign and repent and tremble before God. They will curse God. They will curse the God they say does not exist. I find that ironic. But their anger and rage will also be directed against God's people, especially against those who remind them of this prophecy. Though they see it with their own eyes, they will not be able to understand. Some will see and repent, and we must look and pray for such as those who want the truth. But the vast majority do not want the truth. Now, what are we being told about the weather today?
Global warming!
Then it got colder for a decade, and global warming became climate change. Hey, slogans have to adapt, right?
Due to a marketing breakthrough, the inaccurate ruse has morphed into the theory that cannot be tested or refuted.
Would it be sacrilegious to say that slogans evolve? There have been floods of biblical proportions in Australia. But clearly that is not a temperature issue, neither hotter nor colder. And that is why the language was changed. Global warming, that's a foolish choice. Now it is really about the energy being added to the system. And any storm, any event is held up as proof of climate change. And while the atheists scoff and mock whenever a Christian mentions God's judgment in an event, they now behave exactly the same way for their religion. Any lightning strike, any storm, any drought, any bank overflowed, all offered as proof of climate change. And when these 70-pound, 80-pound, 100-pound hailstones fall, they will not regard the God who foretold the event. They will scoff and scorn anyone who claims it is a sign from God. And they will claim it is the result of man-made global warming. And right now, you who have eyes to see are nodding because you know this is true. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.